Kui showing some great stuff today. Top aiding, taking out a lot of heavy hitters, a lot of big players, a lot of household names in the Brawlhalla competitive universe. So fantastic work coming out from Kui today. And we are still moving on. This is Sandstorm against Wrenched. Sandstorm coming in with this Fate pick that is a little bit new coming out from him. We're used to the Mordex. This is kind of one of the first times we've really seen him dedicate his character choices in tournament to this Fate pick.
I think Sandstorm is going to pull out the Mordex whenever he feels completely threatened to the point where he's like, all right, I have to step it up. But I actually so agree with doing these newer Legend picks, because if he can open up his repertoire a bit more and get away from that Mordex that he has been playing for so long now, we might even see a scarier Sandstorm than we have ever. But Wrenched, man, this dude, I was racking on him and saying that Kui's guitars were looking almost better, but I didn't mean it that way. I messed up a little bit on my wording. What I meant to say is that Kui was a bit more vertical in how he comboed, while Wrenched is more horizontal in how he combos.
Yeah.
And I said, Wrenched, man. And honestly, I'm so happy about Wrench's online performance, because he genuinely does not perform as well as he does on LAN compared to what he does online. Or was that opposite?
Yeah, I would definitely agree with that. On LAN last year, he was regularly a top three placer, and we just don't see that quite carry over into online tournaments, and we definitely don't see that carry over into twos either. So the fact that he's made it to top eight so far, he does have a really tough match on his hands here against Sandstorm. This is in the winner's side of the bracket, though, so even if he does lose this, we could see him go down into the loser's bracket, make a loser's bracket run, but he does have the lead right now, so he might not even have to do this. A win here against Sandstorm would be huge for him.
Incredible.
Totally in their career, they are 2-1 in sets, favoring Sandstorm. The only set that Wrenched won, I don't have that information, but it was before last year. It was before 2018, so that was when... Sandstorm didn't really reach his full peak. That was like pre-world champion level quality Sandstorm. So Wrenched has yet to beat Sandstorm since he's really ascended, since that Storm has really picked up speed.
And honestly, just making, if he does actually manage to make this happen, Wrenched is making top three instantly guaranteed because of winners, how it works to get into winners. But Sandstorm, what is this? What was that? That was like two different reads into another read. Sandstorm, man, always so incredible and so solid with the site. No other player in the game gets as many consistent reads as Sandstorm does. It actually feels like it's a part of the site kit to just combo like that. And then you try it out yourself and you're like, man, I'm going back to sword. I'm not speaking from personal experience, by the way. Anyways. Sandstorm almost making complete comeback. Wrench is such an incredible lead.
Sandstorm just right on the corner. You see him even standing still. He was just waiting to punish the landing with that neutral signature. Now, he didn't charge it. He used it at like probably minimum charge, so it came just the straight up pillar. It didn't kind of explode into that tree of fireworks.
Yeah, and we were talking. Oh my, we were talking about how if Wrench actually does make this, that is going to be his first top three, it's going to be his first top three since 2017 in an online tournament. For how consistent Wrench is offline, it just baffles me that he hasn't made more top three since then. So is this a return to online Wrench form, or will Sandstorm be the person he is?
Probably about 50-50 in online tournaments. He doesn't even make top eight. Like, he has a lot of ninth placements. He has a 14th. He has another ninth. He has 17th. So yeah, the fact that he doesn't even always make top eight in tournaments, despite what we see from him on LAN, this is already a huge step for Rich.
Whoever gets his first game is going to have an incredible lead in the entire set, because that gives you way more time to adapt and allows you to lose upwards of two games without too much worries. This first game is the monumental game, and Sandstorm with that neutral signal fade. We saw Dorbane do it. We saw Dorbane shut out the lights of a lot of people with that signature, and Sandstorm showing up with it as well takes away the hope, even though Wrench was in such a good position and such a good lead at the start of the game.
Now the question is, see, because it was last stock red, I was wondering if Sandstorm was going to be like, okay, that was a little bit too close for comfort. I'm going to switch back to the Mordex and go for the safer pick, the more comfortable pick, the one I won world championships, the one I won final round with. But it looks like his mindset is either I'm going to go with this fate and keep going with it no matter what, or I won with my fate. I don't need to use the Mordex yet. I don't need to bring that out.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, I feel like even if Samsung loses one game, he'd probably still stick to the fate for a bit. I actually feel like until he's on the absolute back foot, he will probably stick to this pick.
That's the benefit of best of five, is like he can lose one. He can lose two games before having to switch to his most comfortable character.
That was so cute how he used that side stick after doing the Nair, but like the range is barely anywhere close to Mordex's. Oh, Samsung, he's down sinks after down sinks. That's not going to kill. One more of those will kill. He just pops out Singer, drops the signature. This man, what is this character? Incredible.
This is disgusting, man.
Mm. What?
Ooh, he hopped over it! He hopped over it! What a cheeky option coming out from Sandstorm, jumping on that star, looking like Kirby running from that blast of light that killed all of his friends. He jumps on that star, gets off the ground, elevated over that side signature. Unfortunately for him, he wasn't able to put out any hitboxes, but he is able to get that kill there with the gravity cancel down light, not turning wrenched around, sending him with higher force and in the direction closer to the blast zone. We saw him get a kill exactly like that yesterday.
However, getting that side into down sink as an old Asuri fashion, whenever you get a down air, whenever you get a side light, you just pop out that down sink and hopefully it hits. Equal up to Scott. Okay. Sometimes you gotta hold your breath, just like see what the option will be from Sandstorm, because you just have no idea. And when you have the edge guard, man, he just finds hit after hit. And when Wrench tries to go back, he's pulls him back real quick. And he's like, nope, now I'm in lead again. Sandstorm's Scythe is something else, but Sandstorm's Orb has been showing up, especially with the signature usage, man. Looking like how the rain did it at Final Round. It feels like Sandstorm was like, you made this?
Yeah.
I made this.
Yeah. And the funny thing is, too, is like we're seeing a lot of the signatures now come out more, but earlier in this game and earlier in the set, we saw a lot of chase opportunities coming out of just the Orb light attacks as well. So he has a huge mastery on both parts of the kits, the light attack and the signatures. He can throw the signatures out safely, get hits. He can tech chase you over and over. He can stick to you like glue, find the right moves to put out constant pressure.
Sandstorm. Okay, does that dash, dash throw kind of hitting nowhere. Probably somewhat of a misinput. Not sure what he was thinking about doing.
Yeah, Sandstorm, that would be my guess. Because it soared quite a bit over Wrench's head.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, Sandstorm's Edgeguard gameplay with Orb so far hasn't been that strong. It seems like, oh, he also dropping that side and decided that would have killed. Doesn't matter. It's an interesting. I think Sandstorm doesn't look as seasoned on the Orb as the other Orb players, like Egg Soup and the Rain as well. However, it's still Sandstorm, and he finds these weird ways of winning neutral. Every time he does, he gets long strings and a lot of damage. That is in true Sandstorm fashion as well, regardless if it's Orb or not. However, Wrench, GC downline recovery, gets the hit.
And we're seeing sort of similar pacing that we saw first game. Like Wrench is just a little bit behind Sandstorm. They're both on their final stock here. You saw last game, it came to last stock red. So Wrench is still definitely keeping pace with Sandstorm. He's just a little bit behind. You're seeing these scythe strings coming out. You saw the signature there as well. He's always like minimum charging them. You don't see him charging them up to sort of get the other option, the other property when you charge them. Going for the down signature, and Wrench punishes that. The second one does hit.
Oh, man. It's so weird. When Sassum does stuff like that, it's not in the Isidru fashion, because it feels like Isidru honestly just does it a part of the game plan. What Sassum does is more like, I kind of feel like it. I'm just going to test it out and have fun with it. It feels almost disrespectful, man. Like, if I were to get hit by that, my mental would break.
Yeah.
Sandstorm, oh my, what? Just move after move, he's wall slipping. Does not matter, gets back on stage. Oh, that's not gonna be it?
That's gonna be the kill.
2-0. Wrench is so close every game, but some part of me feels like
Sandstorm switching to Rayman!
I will say, and
switching to Rayman.
Sparky.
Yes.
Sandstorm beat me on Rayman like 3 times.
Well, yeah, but
don't say that was me. Don't say that was me. I made third place, all right? In 2v2. Dude, this guy's Rayman is actually very legit. Axe signatures are very hard to deal with if you have not dealt with them in the past. I will say that. The side sig or Rayman, am I correct about that? Is it the side sig? The sliding one? Is that side sig or is that down sig? 3, 2, 1.
That
is Rayman.
Oh lord, dude, I don't even remember.
It's Rayman. That's the issue. Ninja Sega's world is so deceptive. However, the sliding signature on Axe is such a hard move to punish, man. And it hits really, really far under, so you can actually catch people when you're edgeguarding. I wouldn't be surprised if this pick actually works out perfectly. Well, Wrench had Katara.
It's not working so far.
Oh, is he dead? Oh, okay. I was like seeing Viper for a moment. I don't know why. Sandstorm is such a good player all around, man. You just see the most optimal things from him all the time.
Getting these gauntlets, he's very familiar with those, especially.
Sandstorm is like the people's champion this tournament, because you asked for the cannon, and he gave you the cannon. And he even tweeted in reply to you, wanted the cannon, I gave you the cannon. And now we're getting Rayman from Sandstorm as well. We saw the Fate from him. He's playing the best skin on Fate. I love that choice. This Rayman pick, man, I'm loving this Rayman pick. My. Let's see what his Axe has, because you have more experience against this Rayman pick from Sandstorm. Like, I haven't really seen this before from him.
Oh my. Sandstorm trying out this thing, just seeing how Wrench is trying to react to it. It's very good to actually just use him just as early as possible, in my opinion, to just see how the opponent reacts to it. And if it doesn't work out, that's fine, because now your opponent is going to be thinking about it. And that's the most important thing. Make your opponent think about something that they weren't thinking about previously, because that allows other options to be opened up instantly. Sandstorm trying his best to get this KO. It was the biggest lead for Wrench was the fact that Sandstorm was unarmed for like the first 30 seconds, and he just straight up kept Katara stringing him over and over and over again. And that gave him this huge lead. So it did not work out in Sandstorm's favor. Wrench killed himself.
Yep. He tried to go a little bit too ham, and now we see they're even on stocks, but Sandstorm is behind. You see him sticking mostly to gauntlets right now. He's going to pick up the weapon toss. He was trying to then pick up his gauntlets again, trying to delay the weapon spawn so Wrench couldn't pick up a weapon. He's definitely more of a gauntlet player so far than he is an Axe player.
Yep.
We've seen that from his Mordex. You're seeing these strings. You're seeing him hit more often, get punished less often with the gauntlets compared to the Axe, and he's already evened it up just like that. The dare, strangely, is going to drop. Mm-hmm.
Sandstorm, however, already made pretty much the lead. It's equal at this point. As I said, I guess the downward recovery does not kill. Rayman actually has a lot of defense as well. Is Rayman not as bad as we thought he would be? Is that what we're seeing?
Rayman might be amazing. I mean, for the right player, I think Rayman can be great. For Wilson, absolutely. 100%. That is a good pickup for Wilson. I think that's a great option that plays to his strengths, that also plays to some other players' weaknesses of not knowing what the heck they're going up against.
Mm-hmm. This is so nerve-wracking. Imagine you're down 0-2, and then one of the best players, if not arguably the best player in 1v1 right now, picks Rayman against you. Do you not want to lose to this, or is it the pressure to the fact that you're already 0-2 that you might lose to it because of that?
I mean, losing to Sandstorm, regardless of what character he's playing, that is a very large possibility. I don't think Wrench should feel bad about that at all. He does have the lead right here. Yep. He's getting Sandstorm closer and closer to kill percent. That is going to kill. They're both on their final stocks here. Yep. Wrench has to be very careful. He's a little bit ahead than he was previously. So he does have to be careful. He has to worry about these gauntlets, which Sandstorm has in his hands.
Oh boy, getting this string. Sandstorm dodging down, however, clean. Gets that thing on it. I mean, gets that defensive option out. I think Sandstorm is pretty much three hits away from making this equal, whether it's Axe or it's Gauntlets, because of how much damage they rack in just quick strings. However, Wrench does not want to lose this, and we can see it. And he's not that afraid. He's going for the kill options. He's trying to get it. He's not overcommitting too hard on anything.
Yeah, he's not fishing for these signatures right now.
That's gonna kill
him. Ooh, beautiful D-Light recovery coming out from Wrench. Going to keep himself alive on this winner's side of the bracket. He's probably going to force the switch back. There it is. That's a level 18 Fate. So he has spent a little bit of time on this Fate, but it's not like it's level 35. Not like it's level 50. Mm-hmm. Definitely not like it's level 60 or 70 or 80 like we see from other players. So level 18 is a little bit sort of lower than what I would have expected coming out from this Fate pick. Still definitely a low character. Of course, he has the carryover from Scythe, from all of the other legends that he plays. And I think when you mentioned that his orb doesn't look as good as some other orb players, it's because he's very new to orb.
Yeah, I fully agree with that. Well, I remember, though, when I was picking up Fate very early when Fate just came out, me and Sanson were talking about like different combos, different approaches, like what can be done in Orb, is Orb a good weapon, all of these things. So it has been in his mind for the longest time. I feel like it was just not an optimal pick of final round because of the fact that his Mordex is so seasoned that final round was a competition of beasts, even though it was literally the first land. However, I do have to say, wasn't Sanson like level 16 yesterday? Now he's level 18.
I didn't notice what his level was yesterday. I mean, it's not that difficult.
Obviously not, but
to gain levels when you're that low. So he could have just gained like one or two levels just from the tournament itself. Mm-hmm. Depending on how long his games are, the fact that he's playing best of threes against people, and especially if they're not all 2-0s, like he could be gaining a decent amount of experience from just his tournament sets. But yeah, I absolutely agree that there is a possibility that after the tournament yesterday, he was scrimming with people and gaining that experience very quickly. So he could have gained two levels just yesterday alone.
One thing about Sanson though, regardless on Fate, is that he has his incredible Scythe gameplay, and as we saw, he got the long spring onto Wrench. Oh, that down thing is into strike coverage, one of the better ledge traps, as I like to call it. Sanson just fishing for these signatures, trying to get one of them to work. Oh, that dude just like he's hitting horizontal. What was that? It wasn't even vertical, it was horizontal.
Now he has a considerable lead on Wrench. After that,
the weapon throw,
it's a dodge read. Fate. Look at that, and he's almost completely evened it up in terms of damage.
That was a close to point blank throw. They were so close to each other, and he used that as his. Oh wow, Wrench with that three piece into weapon throw as well. He can make it almost equal instantly. That was very needed for Wrench to actually cling on to this. However, Sanson does this over and over again. It surprises me that people aren't catching on to this. He will hit you with the weapon throw, wait for the dodge, and then string you. It's such a solid game plan from Sanson's side. And even up to this day, people are still dodging when they get hit by the weapon throw instantaneously. Oh, that's...
Wow! That was almost an incredible read. His positioning was almost perfectly on point with the timing. That was so close.
Sandstorm trying to find this KO opportunity at this point. Wrench, satellite, goes for the read. Does not go for a downlight. He had a pretty much. Why is he not? Hello? Sparky? All of those satellites? Well, at least three of them? What?
That was a point blank ground pound coming out from Wrench. He didn't go for the nair option. He didn't go for the side air option, which probably wouldn't have hit. Don't know the exact perfect precise hitboxing on that. So he went for the point blank ground pound, and he has the lead on this Fate that he might have been struggling for recently, utilizing the unique property of Orb, where if you throw it at the wall with the down air, or you throw it at the ground with the down air, it will bounce off at an angle. You can edge guard so effectively with that tool.
We saw Egg Soup and Dobrain truly show that a lot during final round, where they almost perfectly always kept bouncing it off for edgeguards. However, Sanson showing that he is also able to do that. Wrench confusing me a bit on that last stop because he kept sidelighting but not doing a downlight follow-up afterwards. Maybe it was a bit too damaged. I'm pretty sure I've done it at relatively deep levels. However, Sanson trying to get that reversal, does not get it. Wrench, point black, grab on again. What will the option be? Wait, no, there.
Nice nair. He got his jump reset again, though. Okay. He's having to use everything to get back, and Wrench is just waiting for it.
Side here. This is Wrench's last stock in winner. So this, potentially last stock, I mean. This game is way too important for Wrench to lose. I can't even speak.
Are we going to see the dash jump ground pound? No. Absolutely zero edge guard there coming out from Sandstorm, respecting Wrench.
If that was Mordex, that would have hit, but you're not Mordex.
Yep. There's the sidelight. Tries to go for the dash jump, Sare follow up.
This is so intense.
Oh!
Wrench takes it 2-2.
Wrench keeping himself alive.
Will the Rayman pick come to bite him? Or will Sandstorm instantly pick into Mordex?
He's still sticking with the Fate. He's still sticking with the Fate.
Wrench keeping his composure, getting that kill against, getting that game against Rayman. Pivotal moment for him to truly come back into the game. Now Sandstorm losing his second game. This is an equal 2-2. Anyone can take the last game now. And we will have to see. Sandstorm generally, we don't see Sandstorm flustered very often. And I wonder if this will confuse Sandstorm. I'm not even confused. I wonder if this will truly make Sandstorm a bit more scared going into fifth game. However,
I don't know, man. He is the world champion. He locked in that fate real quick.
And honestly, with his Smash expertise, there is something in me that says that he will actually play better for this game.
Winning this for Wrenched would be huge for a bunch of different reasons. One, the most basic reason, it would put Wrenched into winner's finals, guaranteeing himself a top three spot in this online tournament. Number two, an online tournament. Top three in an online tournament for Wrenched is huge when he's had trouble placing really well in online tournaments compared to LAN in the past. Three, he's against Sandstorm, who he has not beaten in all of 2018. His last victory against Sandstorm in tournament in a set was in 2017. And that was when Sandstorm was sort of like a category three Storm. Mm-hmm. Now he's ramped it up. He's hit that warm water. He is a category five Storm. So Wrench coming in and winning here would be absolutely huge for Wrenched.
Man, all I know is I have a feeling that Sandstorm is going to become a category six Storm and actually just straight up destroy the world.
I don't think that's a thing, so they might have to develop what a category six Storm is the point specifically for this man right here.
Yep.
Look at the difference, though! He has Sandstorm and kill percent, he's barely been touched!
But Wilson did this multiple times in the final round, and every time Sandstorm just got one string and then equaled it up. The amount of times, I keep saying, but the amount of times I saw Wilson beat out Sandstorm in neutral and put damage onto him for Sandstorm to only do one or two hits and come back was ridiculous. Wrench still keeping his composure, does not get gimped right there.
Yep, that could have been a really bad spot for Wrench. That could have been a kill in orange, which would have basically deleted all of the lead that he had. Sandstorm doing a great job catching up very quickly. He placed that down signature perfectly on the weapon spawn. Wrench saw it coming, you saw him move forward and then say, nope, I'm not gonna go for it, backing up. Both players dead even right now. Both in kill percent on their first stock.
Oh, that neutral air to recovery. Getting the K1. As I said, that's what Sandstorm keeps doing. He's behind, finds the actual hit and the most crucial ones. It doesn't matter if you put damage on him, if you can't kill him. Sandstorm always does that.
What a big brain play.
He tosses the weapon diagonally, prevents them from going up, and then just straight up attacks forward. He's done that multiple times on Mordex with his side sig. He's now showing that he can do it on Fate as well.
There's the weapon toss.
That should be it.
He does find the recovery. He is going to be able to get a weapon spawn. I was worried about that weapon toss because he was going to disarm himself against Sandstorm. He was able to find the unarmed recovery for the kill, and then the weapon spawn came in. So he wasn't disarmed for any time whatsoever. Didn't really take any punishment for that.
Oh, that side sig charge. One of the few times we've seen it come out for Sandstorm, and it lands on his target.
There's the Nair.
Yep.
Now Wrench started off this game with a massive lead, but Sandstorm has since deleted that lead, turned it around.
Oh.
Wrench is looking for a strong string here. He doesn't get the dare. He ends up taking two hits afterwards.
One jump left. Okay, Nair. Ground pound. Sandstorm smart. Goes to the other side. Wrench was looking out for blood right there. He was hungry. Singular hits. Wrench trying to just get him into the kill percentage. Sandstorm with that downstick does not kill because that signature is not Fate's absolute best signature.
It's not great. It's probably the worst signature that Fate has in her kit.
Probably one of the worst type signatures in the game, but yeah.
Possibly. I would definitely agree with you on that. It starts with a hurt box, not a hit box, which is not great.
Shoots up for some reason. But it does not matter, and he uses it again for the KO. Sandstorm.
And that's scary. When you can use Fate's worst signature and a very not good signature overall in this game, when you can use it multiple times, leading to a kill, but there's the immediate clapback from Wrench, the side signature going off the stage. Sandstorm was not able to jump on that star and ride to safety this time.
Oh man, that was so quick. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he dashed before that as well, just got that quick racer Formula One straight onto Sandstorm's dome and just sends him flying. Wrench, pretty high octane right now. Both players, actually, they're both swinging wild. Oh, getting that punish, neutral anti-recovery. Orange.
Keep Sandstorm unarmed. If he can keep Sandstorm unarmed, Wrenched has a very high percentage chance of winning this game.
He got blessed by whatever Valhalla god in this game because that literally spawned in front of him.
That was a clutch spawn right there.
He was like, I know it's spawning there. He was like walking towards it. Does he memorize this? It wouldn't surprise me, it's Sandstorm. Oh, getting going for that Sand. Wrench.
They're going so even.
It's the most equal game I've seen. 2-2. Whoever takes this is a winner final. Oh my lord, Wrench with that.
Oh, he doesn't get the Sair.
Does it kill?
Recovery.
One more of those at that. Is that the same distance? Will kill. Oh, waits for a read. Doesn't go for it. Sider.
Game 5, last stock, both players go for it. Oh, he goes for a big read with the ground pound. Gets a little bit greedy there. We aren't seeing any dash jump ground pounds from Sandstorm. That is a staple of his Mordex gameplay.
Oh my lord, he just changed his role. He should not have done that.
Oh, Wrench is unarmed right now. Oh, he goes for the neutral heavy.
Oh,
my gosh. Sandstorm takes his last stock red. About 30 damage difference between the two. That was game 5. Sandstorm is going to be moving on.